This is going to be a quick review on the Harbor Freight Farm Jack. I'm going to do this in two parts. The first part is going to be the general appearance, the build quality, the mechanism. And the second part, if I ever have an opportunity to use it, off-road recovery, I'll do a quick review on that as well. So consider this part one. Now, as you can see on the label, it's the Pittsburgh brand Farm Jack. It's got a 7,000 pound capacity, maximum lifting height 42 inches, minimum height 5 inches. Now, when I picked this up, I was primarily interested in using it for off-road recovery, like I mentioned. I'm thinking as a hand winch would be the best use for me. I don't have the money for a full-blown electric winch. So when I saw this price below 50 bucks, I figured I'd grab it just in case I ever need it. I got some tree straps and snatch straps and things like that that I'm going to put all in one kit and have this in my truck if I ever get stuck. And we'll see what happens. So I'm going to next show you the overall picture and what it looks like, describe its finish, and then show you its mechanism. So my first impression of this is that it's built very solidly. It's heavier than I expected. The finish is pretty good. There's no rough spots in the finish or anything like that. But I did notice that some of it is kind of looking a little rough already. All I've done so far is unbox it, put it in the back of my truck, and do some light trail riding. I don't have it mounted or anything, so it was kind of bouncing around in the bed of the truck when I hit bumps and things like that. So I was expecting some scuffing, and that didn't seem like a terrible thing to me. The handle is one piece, and it's just painted red, nothing fancy. And the lifting bar itself is black, and as you can see, it's just a jack. You're not, you know, if you're buying a toy, that's on you. But I plan on using this, and it'll probably get abused anyway if I ever need to. So as you can see, it's just red and black. The pieces here that are involved in the mechanism that I'll show you shortly, they seem to be solidly built too, and it can't be that different at all from the high lift jack. I just can't see it being that different. Now, there is something to be said about where it's made and the quality of operation you would get with a name brand product. I get that. But for less than 50 bucks, for just in case, even if I use it once, it was well worth it. I'm not some kind of crazy hardcore off-roader. If I was, I would have an electric winch. But this will keep me out of trouble for what I like to do. So again, it seems to be solidly built. It's heavier than I thought. And the finish is what it is. It may or may not hold up forever, but it's going to do its job for me. Starting at the base, you can see that it's bolted on. A lot of the reviews online were complaining about how this is a too small of a base. Now, it can be removed. You could put on a larger base if you're capable of making one. I also see that there's the bolt holes here. Maybe they're not bolt holes, but they can be used as such. You can attach a larger base to the one that's already there. You can remove it, put a bigger one, or attach a larger one to the one that's already there. Now moving up, you see that the lifting bar here has an ovaled out hole, and correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but I believe that's similar to what the high lift jack has. So it looks so far like it's pretty much the same, minus the difference in the base. Now, not having a high lift myself, it's hard to actually say for sure, but so far it looks pretty solid. Moving up, you got the actual, I'm going to call this the claw that that you can use to lift, and you have a pin here to attach it. On the other side is the actual pins that go back and forth, and I'll show you that. You got the label moving up. Now, this bar goes all the way up. It's 48 inches. This is the lever that I'm going to show you in action soon. Going all the way up to the top. I did notice that you have that single hole up there. I don't know if that is different than the high lift or not, but I've seen in some pictures and videos of the high lift that there's another accessory that you can attach there. Maybe that fits on the Harbor Freight. Maybe we'll find out later. Next, I'm going to show you the other side, and I'll show you it actually levering in action. Alright, so here's the base on the other side. As you can see, I just flipped it around. Now, here is the actual mechanism of it all. You got this lever here, okay? And you got that little indent. That's what's keeping this thing from just crashing to the ground. That lever with the indent, okay? Now, if I were to push that down, which I'll show you in a moment, it would take away all the tension and it would just slide straight down. So you have to control that. Now, in the directions, it did say that if there's 150 pounds or more of pressure added to this, it won't come flying down. It'll stay in place even when you push this lever down. I haven't directly tested that yet. That should be in part two if I ever need to. But the other thing I want to point out is you got these pins here. I'll show you what happens there as you can lever it up and down. So that's the next part. I'm going to reposition the camera so you can see it going up and down. All right, so I'm going to show you next how the pins move in and out when you actually lever it. Now, at the moment, this one part that we were pointing at earlier, you have the indent with that little, call it an outdent. That outdent goes into the indent, and what that does is keep it in place. So if I were to physically just pull it up myself, put my foot on the base, and then let go, or at least, you know, stop holding it, it's going to fall down on its own. Okay? If I move this up, lock that into place, move it up, it stays. Okay? So, again, if you're not holding it, I'm going to hold the lever with my left hand and hit this with my right. Right? It's just going to fall. So, what I'm going to show you next is actually the pins going in and out. So, I'll push this back up. Okay? We're going to lever it. Okay? You see how it's just slowly inching up hole by hole with each pump of the lever. And it's all being done by those pins. Now, what the directions said was that this will stay in place if this lever stays here. And if I push it down, it should come flying down. However, it won't come flying down if there's more than 150 pounds of pressure on this claw. If there's 150 or more, even pushing this down, the whole thing will stay in place. What happens then is each pump of the lever gives a reverse action. It goes down instead of up. That allows you to lower the vehicle and things like that in a controlled manner. So, again, hold it with my left, hit it with my right, it comes down. That removes all these pins from these holes and prevents them from holding this whole thing up. It's kind of scary to think that these pins are the only things holding the vehicle up in the air or while winching or lifting a post out of the ground. These pins are doing all the work. So keep that in mind when you're working on this thing. And you have to lower it in a controlled manner. Otherwise, it's very dangerous and you're looking for trouble. Well, I'm going to finish part one by saying, for 50 bucks, you can't seem to go wrong with this thing. It's sometimes on sale with a coupon for 35. So if you get it at the right time with the right coupon, you can get it even cheaper. So for 35 bucks, I think it's a good thing to just have in your off-road vehicle or even around the house if you're pulling posts and things like that out of the ground. If you got to lift something heavy, this will definitely do the job of lifting something heavy and pulling a post out of the ground. Is it a high lift? I don't think so, but I think it'll definitely do the job for the occasional user. And if you keep that lubricated, the mechanism, white lithium grease or even silicone spray, it should keep you very happy. So I hope this helped and good luck.